In the year negative a billion, two tectonic plates, the Eurasian plate and the Indo-Australian plate, met in the outskirts of the Indian Ocean. The Eurasian plate beat the Indo-Australian into submission and formed what is called a subduction zone. The beatdown weakened the crust, allowing magma and gas to rise to the surface. Until bam, a brand new baby volcano was born. The first eruption of Krakatoa is lame compared to the one on August 26th and 27th of 1883. You see, what had happened was, Krakatoa was
dummy hungry.
He decided he wanted a spicy Asthenerito from Rocco Bell. Well, the food didn't sit well with him, and gave him igneous gestion. Gas and pressure were building inside his magma chamber. He tried to hold his composure because Mount Merpai was looking straight at him. The pressure kept building, but Krakatoa couldn't hold it. Krakatoa was relieved that his eruption wasn't too bad, except for it ripping a giant hole in his side, which caused seawater to rush into the magma chamber, and it boiled instantly. The explosion plus the steam and pressure it created caused an unearthly explosion. The explosion threw thousands of pounds of ash, lava, and debris miles into the atmosphere. A thick black cloud of super hot ash blocked out all sunlight within a 250-mile radius for 3 whole days. Get up, Johnny. It's time for school. I wish it was nighttime again. Yay. The only thing was that this ash was super hot and basically torched anything it touched. Village, plants, animals, and even people were burned to the ground. Debris was reported to fall 620 miles away. Even ships 3,700 miles away reported ash falling onto their decks. They described it as the first snow of winter. Hey, John, it's snowing. Dude, it's August. 36,000 people were killed from the explosion and the hot ash itself. This wasn't even including the 120-foot tsunami the collapse of Krakatoa caused. The tsunami destroyed 165 coastal villages, as well as launching 600 tons of coral on dry land. Good luck finding Nemo now. It also managed to destroy a cargo ship, killing all 26 crew. The ash cloud eventually got higher into the atmosphere, which caused the average global temperature to drop by 34 degrees over 5 years. All in all, the infrastructure in the surrounding islands wasn't built to withstand a full-force volcano and tsunami, and the technology of that day wasn't able to warn people of the impending danger. The eruption was considered to be the loudest sound in history. It was heard over 3,000 miles away, a distance longer than the United States. The blast also had a force of 10,000 atomic bombs. If someone dropped 10,000 atomic bombs off the coast of North Carolina, then someone in Seattle, Washington would be like,
"Did someone say something?"
The collapse of Krakatoa gave birth to another volcano, which remains active to this day. So I guess the lesson learned today was Rocco Bell, not even once.